Hello, wonderful people of God, and welcome to Meaningful 5 Minutes with Mommy Reads. We want to heartily thank you all, as usual, for your views, even the silent views, your likes, your comments, your shares, and of course, your subscriptions. We pray that as you continue to do so, before this month of August comes to an end, you will certainly meet that August visitor with good news for you in Jesus' name. Yes, we've been telling ourselves from slot one that salvation was made possible because Jesus died on the cross of Calvary for you and for me. And so if you are yet to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, make no delay, for no one knows what the future holds. Hallelujah. Yes, we've been deliberating on several topics from slot 1 to 88, the last being the fact that the way up is the way down, and we are called upon to serve people regardless of their class in society, regardless of their age, their academic portfolio, their spiritual background, without expecting anything in return, because that is the kind of service that God certainly rewards. Hallelujah. And so today in slot 89, we'll be looking at the topic under the umbrella. Praise the Lord. We have as main passage Isaiah chapter 43 verse 2, where we are told, though when you go through the fire, you will not be consumed, and when you go through the water, you will not be overwhelmed. Beloved in the Lord, the Bible did not say if you go through the fire. The Bible says when you go through the fire. It means there are times in life when, even as children of God, even as bona fide believers, even as servants of God, you are called upon to go through challenges. You are called upon to go through difficulties, through situations that will make you question your faith, that will make you doubt, that will make you fear, that will make you worry, that will make you panic. But we have the assurance that when we go through those situations, God is not going to leave us. God is not going to let us down. If you look at, this is autumn and rainy season in many countries. When you are under the umbrella, this does not stop the rain from wetting your feet. What the umbrella does is it just prevents you from getting soaked. You will not get soaked, but you will get wet. And so it's the same thing even in the spirit realm. When you are for Jesus, or when you are believing in God, that does not mean that you are spared from challenges or you are spared from difficulties. What it simply means is that you will go through the difficulties like every other person, but you have the assurance that you are under the umbrella. You have the assurance that God is on your side. And so what is consuming the others, what is killing the others, will definitely not kill you. Hallelujah. Some of us are going through different kinds of fires in our lives, different kinds of challenges. It can be your health. It can be trusting God for a life partner to the point where you have become a laughing stock. Maybe you are out there waiting for the fruit of the womb until they now use that situation to describe you, or you are out there trusting God for a job, or you are in a difficult marriage and you are thinking of quitting, or you are in a spiritual situation where you are trusting God for breakthrough, you are trusting God for ministerial open doors and nothing seems to be happening, or maybe you are finances get worse by the day and you are beginning to ask yourself questions whether it is really worth it, whether God has forgotten your case, or whether the angels in charge of your case have been arrested in the spirit realms. My brother, my sister, it is not time to give up. It is not time to lose hope. It is not time to question God, because we have the assurance that when, and not if, when we go through the fire, when we go through the storms, when we go through the waters, we will not be consumed. God will certainly make a way out. Some of us, because of challenges, because of situations, we have done things that we are not proud of. We have put our hands in places where we were not supposed to. Or we have interacted with people who have led us astray. Or we have even sought help in places where, under normal circumstances, we should not have gone to. But it is not time to give up. It is not time to blame yourself. What God is interested in is how much you are willing to make amends. We are told in Proverbs 24 from verse 16 to 18, 7 times a righteous man falls, but the Lord lifts him up. My brother, my sister, don't look at where you have fallen and remain on the ground. Instead, run to the Savior, the one who is able to make everything brand new. Some of us are going through the kind of challenge that we are beginning to wonder whether it is worth it to stay under the umbrella, under the refuge of God. But we should remember that we are told in Psalms 46 from verse 1 to 3 that God is our refuge, a present help in the time of trouble. So even when trouble comes, rest assured, God is your refuge. God is your umbrella. You will definitely not be soaked. You might get a little bit wet, but you will get to your destination dry you will get to your destination safe. And so if you are out there, you have not given your life to Christ, or maybe you're giving your life to Christ, but because of circumstances, you have backslidden, or you are wondering whether it is worth it. My brothers, my sisters, just bow your heads and say, Lord Jesus, I acknowledge that I am a sinner. Wash me with the blood of the Lamb. Take me back as your child. Holy Spirit, come and take control of my life. Give me the power to live right. Give me the power to hate sin. And behold, God's arms are open to take you back as his child. Beloved in the Lord, even under the umbrella, we will get wet, but we will not get soaked. We will definitely overcome the challenges of life. The Bible remains the road, Jesus the code, sin the obstacle, and heaven the destination. Shalom, good people.